coming from a guy who sells oil, it's a strange take, but I am for cheaper electricity, reusable energy, and solar power. That's all there is to it.
Well, our community, we're on diesel. And diesel, as we all know, diesel fuel prices are not going down. They're constantly on the rise. It just, fuel prices are keeping our utility rates high.
Almost all of the homes within Southeast Alaska are warmed by heating oil. Other parts of the state have natural gas to heat their homes, but Southeast Alaska is not on that gas pipeline system. We are as isolated as you can be. We're in an island archipelago.
We pay probably like 10 times more than the rest of the people in the lower 48 in the United States.
I have a really good paying job, but when you have a family and I live in a big house, my electricity bill has been ranging to $300 to $400 this summer.
If I want an electric range in my house, electric hot water heater, electric dryer, electric washing machine, all that good stuff, my electricity went up $700-$800 a month.
Some light bills run up to $1,200. Just in how people pay that here, when you have no jobs here, it's just mind-boggling.
Because I've been trying to go back to school since I've been back here, taking classes online, because I'd like to finish my education, and I had to give up my education so I can afford to pay my electricity bills. So it's tough. It's really tough.
It doesn't cost too much now, so I have to go get this so I can have oil. Fuel oil.
Southeast Alaska is in the middle of the Tongass National Forest, over 17 million acres of forested lands. The oil that comes from the Alaska pipeline bypasses Southeast Alaska completely and is sent down to the lower 48 to be refined and is ultimately shipped back up by a barge company and redistributed it out to the rest of the state. That means is that Alaska pays the highest cost of energy in the nation, and it's most of that resource is coming directly from our own state.
The oil barge is coming in, and one of the things we tend to worry about is spills. Hopefully nothing goes wrong, because we got these big 20,000 gallon tanks of fuel.
There's always a danger of an oil spill, or for some reason maybe not having a good supply. And in 2008, it was very difficult because, as you know, that was when fuel prices spiked to outrageous amounts.
We can't keep polluting our planet. The price of diesel is just not gonna go down.
It's a demonstration project, so we're working on one house and we're seeing what the possibilities are with that one house. And right now we're doing Peggy and Kelly Williams' house, and we're installing solar panels and doing weatherization, making some other improvements, and we're going to see what the possibilities are after that project is over and see if, solar energy can be done here in a rural community in Alaska.
We call it the green workforce. The new workforce for tomorrow is going to be a green workforce. It's not going to be the diesel dinosaur mechanics of old. It's going to be people maintaining solar panels and wind turbines and hydroelectric projects and the utility lines that go with them.
Well, we're very interested in renewable energy. And, when you compare it to diesel, and I just don't think that oil is going to get any cheaper. I think it's probably just going to keep going up and up as it becomes more and more scarce.
Well, we've always been looking at renewable energy as a solution to the problem, for the high cost of energy. There's been a group of guys here that have been looking at it on the internet, and they're all excited, and they say, let's try this, and then there's another group saying it will never work. So this is kind of going to weigh it out for us. This will either show them it does work, you're right, it doesn't work.
If we wanted to, we could go and borrow all the money to do these projects. However, then that all has to be paid back with interest, of course. And, And that's okay. But the worst thing we want to do is go and spend a lot of money on a project and end up having rates that are higher than what they were with diesel.
In the summertime, before I go home and subsist and guide, I do know that when the cruise ships come in, you see this thick layer of smoke building up on the, halfway up the mountain. And it couldn't be a good thing. You know, the diesel exhaust sitting at a certain level on the mountain. It has to have an impact to the environment. And putting everybody on solar and turbine, it's got to make a difference.
See what happens.
Mm-hmm. Right now, my guy is prepping the outside of the house for the outside insulation we're going to install.
This is the first time that outside insulation technique has been done in Angoon, and that's like your house puts on a coat of insulation outside the structure of the house. You don't have to go in the walls or in the roof or anything.
It's like putting a nice down coat on.
It's always time for a little bit of tomfoolery. I mean, you just set that.
gotta get it done.
Well, you see, I don't have to get it painted off.
It has
the same. This is the stuff. See, they don't supply this.
Wait up.
Excited about it, because if we can prove any technology in the village that can help to better their lives, I'm all for that.
By doing this, you're adding hope to what we already know could be. I mean, that this renewable energy could have a positive impact here in Angoon if it works. And that's all we've ever been looking for, is solutions to problems, and this has the potential of being a really good solution to a major problem.
The energy savings from this bulb are worth $1,000 in Angoon with the energy price you pay. So by changing out one of these bulbs for one of these bulbs cost about $30. They're expensive, but it's worth $1,000.
Our best way to help our people is to get a lower cost energy source so that we can pass on those savings.
It's the only way to go. I don't think that the oil industry is really going to give up their grip on the world. But eventually, we have to win. In order to save our Earth, like they say, you know, progress isn't really all that great on the long run. We've destroyed a lot of things by the dollar. The power of the dollar has destroyed a lot of things. Now, it's going to cost a lot of generations, a lot of their time and expertise to get back Mother Earth. Are we going to succeed? There's a lot of minds we have to change within everybody's lifetime so that our grandchildren can enjoy this earth as much as we have.
Yeah.
Angoon.